Hey, what's going on, everybody? Welcome to yet another episode of the Maxed Ultimate Ironman series, where I attempt to fill as many collection log spots as possible, starting out here on 829. I got a lot done in the last video. If you guys remember, the first thing I did was go and get the Vorkath head so I can make my assembler max cape, and then I moved into doing the new Tormented Demons, and I ended up green logging that in 269 kills. And then I was able to go and make my Emberlight. And since I got the Emberlight, I decided to head over to Demonic Gorillas. And I got my first zenyte to make my Necklace of Anguish. So that's where we're starting out here. 268 total kills so far. And I am still looking for 3 more zenyte shards to make all of the items. Also still looking for the heavy frame and the monkey tail, which are both 1 in 1500 drop rate. So those are pretty rare. I'm still continually doing these off task. Even off task, surprisingly though, I'm still getting upwards of 50 kills per hour. I could definitely push towards 60, paying like a lot of attention. I also changed around my inventory a bit from the last video. I'm bringing 4 prayer pots, 2 super combats, 2 ranged potions, and 6 total sharks. But yeah, hopefully I can get spooned another zenyte and I can make the amulet. Also, if you guys are new here and you do end up enjoying the video, I'd really appreciate it if you could drop a subscription on the channel.
Oh no. There's light frame number 2 on 343 KC. Ballista spring number 2. 410 KC. Ballista limbs number 3. Another limbs. Jeez, man. Yes, zenyte number 2. 464 KC. Nice. And I can go make the amulet to get rid of my fury. Okay, I went and got all the supplies that I need once again to make the next zenyte item, which means it is time to lose 30,000 chaos runes again. Alright, let's go ahead and make this second zenyte item, which is going to be the amulet of torture. Attach that. And the final part here, enchant it. There we go, the amulet of torture. Now I can go ahead and get rid of my fury.
Another set of ballista limbs. And those are going to be on 761 KC. So it's been quite a while since the last time. I believe the last update was on like 460 or something when I got the second zenyte. Oh my gosh, I just got a back-to-back. Literally back-to-back. I just got... Look at that, ballista zenyte shard. I didn't even have the recording going because I was going to save the clip. That's... Wow. Like I said, 761 before, so 762 KC now. So when it comes to the zenyte that I just got and also the fourth one that I eventually get, I'm just going to be keeping them in my looting bag. I don't really have any need for the other two items yet, so I'll just be making those later on. Also, so far from this grind, you guys will see on the floor here, I have a total of 11 hard clues and 2 elite clues stacked up. There's another set of ballista limbs. That is, I believe, the 5th time I've gotten this drop. Sadly, no live reaction to this one, but that is the 4th zenyte completed now on 962 total kills. Sorry to all the people out there that go like 1,000 kills without getting their first zenyte. So here's what the log is looking like so far. Honestly, a decent amount of drops for having about 1,000 kills. I'm at 990 right now. I have a lot of clues stacked up, and it's kind of getting annoying to keep resetting them, so I want to take a quick break to go and get rid of all of these. I did also want to mention, I am going to be staying here to go for the other two items. I'm not going to be moving on after getting the fourth zenyte. I do want to try to get this entire log green. There's all of the clues completed, 3 elites and 14 hearts to open. I'll be starting out here with the elites, where, as you guys know, it's been, I think, like 40 or 50 elites since I've gotten any unique. Oh, yep, there it is. The first elite, I got a briefcase. Nice. Also, a giant boot, which is another unique that I already have. But finally, I get a unique from an elite, man. Let's keep going with these. Maybe I can get another one. And I get a mimic, actually. That's like the best I could hope for from elites. Well, that was the easiest mimic I've ever done. Literally didn't even use a single piece of food. I went and filled my whole inventory with sharks. I didn't even need any of them. Here we go, though. As you guys see in the chat there, that is mimic number 10. Let's go ahead and open it. Hopefully, I get the third age ring. 905k for this? These teleports must be worth like a lot or something. Yes, 674k for these teleports, jeez. Okay, back over here in birth. Onto the hard caskets. Zamorak Coif, that's a pretty nice item to get. I also got another stole that I already had from the clue beforehand. Guthix Bracers as well from the very next hard clue. I can't open any hard clues without getting a master. These detours are always crazy when I go and open these clues. Little hard clue milestone there, that is number 200.
And on 202, a Rune Helm H2, and also another pair of Armadil Chaps that I already had. Another Master as well to do now, so that's two. Final two Hard Caskets, here we go. Another Master. Back-to-back Masters, wow. And the final Hard Casket here for No Unique. But I am going to go do these three Masters. Sadly, I wasn't able to complete one of the Masters. It was for a stash that I didn't have. Thankfully, on that one, though, it was step one, so I didn't really waste too much time on it. I do have two here to open, though. It's going to push me up to 50 Masters. So let's go ahead and open these two. First one, No Unique, and number 50. Nothing as well, sadly. So at this point, I am going to make my way back over and continue with Demonics. Wow, okay, another Zenyte. That's number 5 on 1,085 total kills. Okay, here's another update. I am currently at 1,218. A few more hards and an Elite here that I'm going to be doing. I need to take a break from Demonics, I'm not gonna lie, it's so much clicking, I wanna chill and just like watch a TV show or something. I was thinking about what I could do for a break here that's really chill that could be good on a log. Of course, as you guys know, I am trying to go for as many pets as I can, so I'm gonna head over to Temp. I'll probably do like maybe 10 to 20 hours, so like 2 days of this. A few more caskets here, let's go ahead and open them and start with the Elite. And now I have 5 hards to open, I'm kinda just gonna go through these really quickly. And a Cyclops head from the last hard clue, nice. So another unique from those. Before I get everything I need for doing temp, here's everything I have on my account if you guys want to like pause this and look through it or anything. But it is up to 856 mil now, which is pretty nice. The temp log itself has 12 total slots. Of course, including the pet. I'll go over the rates on all of this stuff later when I do the reward pool. So I've actually never done temp before, so I had to go and look at videos on this. So when it comes to the method that I'm going to be using here, I'm going to be doing the firefighter method. For those of you that have never done the firefighter method before, it's supposed to be between 75 and 80 permits per hour. So really quick with this method, you first start off by catching and cooking 17 fish, and then going back up to the ship and putting them in the cannon. Then you head back down and get 19 more, head back up to the cannon, put them in again, and then at that point you go over and you basically start doing damage to temp from the pool. So once the shield goes back up, you get as many buckets as you can, use humidify to fill them all with water, and then just go around the front of the island here putting out as many fires as you can. And then after that, I'm going to repeat the process of fishing and cooking 19 more fish, going up, putting them in the cannon, going back down, doing damage to temp, and getting the buckets once more, except for the only difference is this time, I'm going to be running around the entire island and putting out the fires on the far side of the island. It is a lot of clicking. I think you go through like 4 humidifies or something. You put out probably like, honestly, 100 fires per run. The reason this method is so good, though, is because you get a ton of points for putting out the fires. Once all those are put out and I see that the storm is getting close to 100%, I'm going to catch 2 more fish and then put those back in the cannon and finally head down and finish off the kill. And you'll see in the chat there the amount of time it took and also the amount of reward permits that I got from it. It usually averages out to about 11 minutes and you get 15 reward points. And then of course you have like the 30 seconds to a minute of starting the next game. So yeah, like I said, I'm probably gonna do this for like 10 to 20 hours just for a little break. So that's the final temp like KC combat achievement there, which means I've done 6 out of the 8 total combat tasks. I'm gonna try to get both of the other ones done together on the next run, up to 139 permits now. As you guys see in the chat there, I just finished the easy combat task Fire in the Hole, and I should get another one here, Dress Like You Mean It, which is a hard combat task, and also with that, should be 8 out of 8, and all of the temp combat tasks completed. So let's scroll through here and go down to temp. Yep, there it is, 8 out of 8. Those are all pretty easy. Another update on the total permits, 506. I should be able to hit around 1,000 today, so I'm definitely going to set that as my goal. Another permit update, a little bit over 750. So about 16 hours or so later, as you see in the chat there, 1,003 total permits. I am going to be stopping temp here for now and going and doing all these searches. For the permits here, you just AFK this fishing spot and you get rewards in your inventory. It's basically the same thing as Guardians of the Rift when you go for the rewards there. So there's 12 things total on the collection log. The two really big items are the pet, which is a 1 in 8,000, and also the dragon harpoon, which is 1 in 8,000 as well. There is 2 more things on here that are kind of a high rate. It's 1 in 1600 to get the Tome of Water, and a 1 in 1600 to get the big harpoon fish as well. Everything else on here is a pretty low drop rate though. Oh, there's a tackle box already, which is a 1 in 400 drop right here. And also, as you guys saw earlier, of course, they got these spirit flakes, which you use to add to the angler outfit to make the spirit angler outfit, I believe it's called. So another unique item there, some soaked pages. Once again, it's only a 1 in 53 drop rate. Hey, there's a pretty big one, a 1 in 1600 drop rate with the big harpoon fish. Nice. That's only 200 searches in as well. There's the fish barrel as well. 300 searches, and I already have a ton of stuff in this log here. I can show you guys 306 searches, and I have 5 out of the 12 items ready. All 4 of these I'll be able to get, I think, from all the spirit flakes I have already, so technically 9 out of the 12 items so far. There's the halfway point, 500 total searches done, no more uniques yet. Another update here on the searches, up to 900, so sadly only 100 left to go. Well, that's all the searches done with, 1,003 total. Like I said though, I can go get the spirit angler set, which I can do by talking to this NPC here. Hopefully I can just go through these one by one, I don't have to go through all the dialogue. Oh yeah, you can, nice, so yeah. It's only 1,200, I think, per, so it's 4,800. I have way more than enough for that. So there's all 4 of those. And yeah, heading into the log now, just those 3 items left to go, which I'll come back for eventually. Also a bunch of random items in my inventory. I'm going to hang on to the sea turtles for sure for going back to demonics. They heal more than the sharks, and I have like 1,000 of them, so that'll actually be helpful for me. Before that, though, I have 51 of these caskets here, and these, I think, give like random rune items and a bunch of clues. I'm going to open all those little caskets that I got from doing the boss. Pretty decent amount of stuff from it. I have 1 hard clue, 2 mediums, and it looks like 5 easies that I'm going to do. Also in my inventory is a bunch of all the other stuff I got from it. I actually got 3 total crystal keys that I can go and use on the crystal chest on top of that, which is really cool. I also mentioned I was going to be using the sea turtles as food. I didn't even realize that I got manta rays from that as well. And those heal 22. Sharks heal 20, so I'm definitely going to be using these. Made all 3 of my enhanced crystal keys. Hopefully I can get another tooth half from this as well for the other loop that I have. But let's go ahead and go for it here. Some sharks, some more rubies and diamonds, and sadly I didn't get another tooth half, but there is 9 total chests now opened. When I got all of these clues done, let's go ahead and start opening these. A duplicate imp mask there, and from the rest of them, doesn't look like I'm going to get anything. Now into the 2 mediums, nothing from the first one, and a Lovakenge banner from the second one. Always nice to get another medium unique. And finally, let's go ahead and open the hard casket. Nothing from that. Up to 844 total log slots now though with the banner. If you guys noticed, I've had that Hispori ready thing on my screen for quite a while. I wasn't really able to go and do it while I was doing temp because I would have had to keep the Spori seeds in my inventory. But 50 total done now, and still no bucket. I really hope I get this done in these next 8 seeds. I do not want to have to go back to doing seaweed right now for more spory seeds. But time to head back to Demonic Gorillas. Ooh, there's another little update. 55 million total strength XP. Yes! Let's go! Heavy frame, I only have 1 drop left to go now, which is the monkey tail. 1,329 KC for that, so I still have a chance of finishing this log under rate. And if you look in the chat there, just hit 20 million ranged XP. Oh, there is Ballista Limbs number 6 on 1,460 kills. Here's another KC update, I just hit 1,500. Which is the rate on the monkey tail, so I am going to be going dry on that. Overall, though, I am pretty happy with how the log's going. If I can get this before maybe like 2,500, I'll definitely still be happy with it. There's a drop I definitely did not want to see, a dragon spear, which is 1 in 36,000 here. Kind of a daunting number. Another light frame that is, I believe, number 3, and that is going to be on 1,652 KC. Another update on the kill count, 1,728. Not gonna lie to you guys, I need a break from this. It's incredibly boring. That little temp break I took just really wasn't enough. Also, it's pretty common on Ultimate Iron Man for people to make like a Ring of Suffering, do a bunch of Zolra, and then drop the Ring of Suffering. And when they need more skills in the future, they come back to get another Ring of Suffering here. So I'm just gonna leave the Monkey Tail for sometime in the future if I have to go back for another Zenyte to get another Ring of Suffering. But yeah, I really want to just move on here and keep going with PVM. I really want to do Zolra and Bandos, so next thing I'm going to be doing is working on Zolra. I'll probably end up staying here until I get all 3 of the uniques. When it comes to like the pet, the mutagens, and the jar and stuff, This could take a really long time, so I'm not going to be sitting here and trying to green log the entire thing in one sitting. Before I move on to that, though, I wanted to show you guys the entire drop log from Demonic Gorillas. Let's show that on the screen right here. 117 million GP, a ton of GP in Alks too. I think it made like 20 million GP or so in Alks. Also, if you guys see in the corner over here, I do have four more hard clues that I've been juggling. All right, four more hard caskets. Here we go. Just going to kind of spam through these really quick. Of course, get another master. I swear, every time I do these, I need to make like another detour just to do a master. And the other two, no unique from those, so... see what the first step of this master clue is. It is really easy. All right, that one was really quick. Took me like 15 minutes to do. Let's go ahead and open another master casket. Never lucky. So there's a few things I need to do before Zolra. One of them is kind of annoying. Let me see if I can find this log in here. So they added this teleport to the Tormented Demons log. So I'm going to go back and get that really fast. 1 in 12 drop rate, so it won't take too long. I still have my Greater Demons task as well. Actually, right on drop rate too, I did exactly 12 kills for that. Also, I'm an idiot, and I went and put my Black Mask in my looting bag, so I had to do this with a Crystal Helm. Yeah, Tormented Demons, green logged once again. I'm going to get a few things that I put into my inventory here. Number one is, as of last update, can store the Ember Light and the Arc Light stash now. Thankfully, I was risking holding onto this until they did that update, so yeah, if it took them months to do, I would have had a permanent inventory slot. I also had to go get another Amulet of the Damned because for some reason the one I had in here wasn't full anymore, so I wasn't able to put it in my looting bag when I used it, but now that I got the other one, as you see, I can store it back in the stash here. The other thing I wanted to talk about is all these items you guys see up here at the top. I'm going to be dropping off my account. I've been hanging on to the Varix plate skirt for a while. I got both of these because I said it was kind of like bandos. I'm not going to be needing these at all because I'm just going to be using ranged for the next few grinds I'm doing. And I'm going to be going to bandos pretty soon anyway, so there's really no point to me holding on to these. As for the Burning Claw, I mentioned why I was holding on to this. I'm not going to lie, it was a cope hold. I'm going to get rid of this too. I really don't see Burning Claws being useful for me since I have a Void Waker already. And also the Watermelon Seeds. I was holding on to these because you need them for an elite step, but now that I'm getting more items on my account, I need to open up some more looting bag space. So yeah, all five of these items I'm going to drop over to my other account. Also, now that I am moving out to Zolra, I need to make my Ring of Suffering. So I went and got another Onyx, made it into a Zenyte. 30,000 more Chaos Runes for that, so this is down to 66,000 now. Yeah, I'm going to go ahead and make the ring, then imbue it into the Ring of Suffering. So now I need to charge this with Rings of Recoil. The method for this, I have a pretty good idea of how this works. I've never done it before, but I need to get myself a decent amount of Tockle. There's a shop where you can actually buy gold ore and also uncut sapphires at the same time. So basically what I'll be doing is just buying each of those. I'll be chiseling the uncut sapphires as I run north towards the furnace. Then of course, once I get to the furnace, I'll make the gold bars and then turn them into Rings of Recoil. Then on my way back, I'll enchant them into Rings of Recoil, add them to my ring, and then hop worlds and basically start the whole process over. I'm gonna have to do some math on how many recoils I wanna make for now, since once you put them in the ring, of course the ring becomes untradeable, and if I wanna put it in my looting bag, I need to uncharge it, and then I lose all of my recoil charges, so I wanna make sure I don't do too many. Okay, I'm out of Tockle. I had to use like, I think 100,000 is what I went and started with. I have 16,266 charges, which is a little bit over 400 rings. In terms of how many I was making per hour, it was a little bit over 300, so it really wasn't too bad. Once I get to doing Zora, though, I'll get an idea of how many recoils I'm gonna need per kill. It took me a while to figure out everything I wanted and get the inventory set up. First thing I want to say is I'm kind of surprised on how much space I have here to fill my inventory with food. It's gonna change when I start getting some drops I need to keep in my inventory, like scales and whatnot, but this is what I'm gonna be going with. The full crystal, of course, have my Ring of Suffering, the Necklace of Anguish now. Also going to be bringing my Zami Dehyde Boots. For the inventory for now, I'm just going to bring one Range Potion and two Prey Pots. I'll change this around depending on how much I need. In terms of my looting bag, I have a total of three slots open right now, which I'll probably be filling with Dwarf Weeds, Toad Flax, and Torstals. The main things I'll be keeping here are just going to be the herbs. But yeah, let's get to this. I'm not going to lie, I haven't done Zolra for a really long time. I did like 6,000 total kills on my normal Ironman account, but that was over like 7 years ago or something. So by this time, I've completely forgot all the rotations. Well, other than the diary kill, there's the first actual Zora kill. It took me 2 minutes and 43 seconds, and went a lot better than I was expecting it to with not having done this for so long, as I mentioned. There's a quick collection log for getting a Zora teleport on the third kill.
Also, new personal best, up to 2 minutes and 7 seconds, is yet another PB on 5 kills with 1 minute and 54 seconds. Ooh, the first elite clue of many here. I'll be doing the same thing as usual on all of these and just stacking these clues outside and doing them all at the same time when I'm done. These are a 1 in 75 chance here, though. Another PB, 1 minute and 47 seconds. There's another PB, 1 minute and 34. I'm definitely already getting this down. I almost have all the rotations memorized after like an hour. There's a hard combat achievement for getting 25 kills. Okay, 50 total kills now. PB is still the same, 1 minute and 34. And I want to say I'm averaging about 18 kills per hour right now. I'm hoping to get it up to between 20 and 25.
That was a really fast kill. It's got a combat achievement with that too. 1 minute and 16 seconds from that. That was actually kind of crazy. On 60 KC, I believe the fastest one is like 55 seconds or something, so I don't think I'm going to be able to get that with my current gear. Still a cool combat task to get, though. Hey, it's another combat task. I didn't realize I was going to get for 75 kills, I guess. An elite combat task, so 4 more points. Oh, well, there's the first unique drop being an Onyx, which honestly, I'm not upset about. I still have the other Zenyte to make. I was kind of saving this until I got an Onyx here. I didn't want to waste the Chaos Runes in case it happened, but that's on 83 KC. I'm not going to make it just yet since I still have space in my looting bag, but that is going to be for the Mage Bracelet. Shout out to George Alone in the Clan Chat, but he just reminded me that with this Onyx, I also have Zalk Greenlog now. Since if you guys remember when I was doing it before, I said I'd eventually get it from Zulra. So yeah, Greenlog Zalk. That's pretty cool. Another boss out of the way. Okay, KC milestone here. Just hit 100 total kills. And as you guys saw, the only unique I have so far is the Onyx. 21,911 total skills already though, which is obviously really nice for once I get the items. I'm going to be ending this video here though, up to 848 total collections logged. Surprisingly, this is going up really fast. Next video, I'm just going to keep doing Zulra. I'll probably take a break here and there to do some more temp. Maybe spoon that pet along the way. Thank you guys per usual. Hope you enjoyed this one, and I will see you once again next Sunday at the usual time with another one.